All right, so we talked through how it works when you've got you're trying to fit your data to a constant function, a zero order polynomial, but let's at least talk through how you do this in the more general case. This is what I've been doing to fit various curves to the data, at least implicitly. So what we're really trying to do is we've got a set of data, x and y, n examples of x's and their corresponding y's. And what we're trying to find is these coefficients, c0, c1, c2, c3. Let's say if we're trying to do cubic regression, where c0 gets added to c1 times x, which gets added to c2 times x squared, which gets added to c3 times x cubed. And we're trying to get that to look a lot like y. Now, we're not going to get it to exactly equal y, but let's pretend for a moment that we could. We have a bunch of these examples, and we want it to work for all of them. So we can arrange all of the all these constraints, all these equations, into matrix form, if you're familiar with linear algebra. So the way that we can write this is, here are the coefficients that we're looking for, the c's, and here are what we're going to multiply them by. We're going to take the x1 and look at the 0th power, the first power, the second power, the third power, and that equation, I'll use my hands because that's I always need to use my hands when I do matrix multiplication. So you're going to go across here and down there to multiply these and add, and that needs to correspond to y1. And same thing, this now, the second row multiplied by these coefficients need to give us our y2 and so forth. All right. So if we arrange all these x values into a matrix, and we'll call it, you know, x, and then we have these other guys, and we'll call this w, like the coefficients. Obviously, w stands for coefficients. And we want that to sort of equal this vector of y's. And we basically just need to solve this equation for the w's. Now, we can't exactly solve it because it's not going to exactly equal, but we can solve it in a least square sense. So let me just step through the steps for doing that. All right, so here's how we're going to solve for w. So what we're going to do is pre-multiply by the transpose of x, both sides. I mean, really what we wanted to do at first is if we're solving for y, we need to multiply by the inverse of x. But this isn't really going to necessarily be well-behaved. But if we pre-multiply by the x transpose, then this thing is going to have a nice inverse. So now we can pre-multiply by that inverse. All right. Now, conveniently, because this has a nice inverse, and inverses cancel each other, we get that the weights we're looking for can be derived by taking the x matrix times its own transpose, inverting that, multiplying by x transpose, and then multiplying it by the y. And that gives us exactly the coefficients that we need to have done our polynomial regression. And it just so happens that we have some nice properties in terms of these x transpose x. Not only is it invertible, but it does the right thing in terms of minimizing the least squares. It does it as a projection. Now, we're not going to go through the process that by which we argue that this is true.
Does it have something to do with calculus?
It most likely has something to do with calculus. And we'll get back to calculus later. But in this particular case, we're just using projections in linear algebra. And most importantly, the whole process is just we take the data, we arrange it into this matrix with whatever sort of powers that we care about, and then we just compute this quantity and we're good to go.
Okay.